Hi there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data, and in this video we're going to explore the new version of Google Search Console. We're going to look at the new interface, the most important changes you should be aware of, and how you can use the performance report to optimize the content on your website. The new version is rolling out globally, and Google says it's been designed to simplify the process of optimizing a website's presence on Google Search. So let's take a look at the new Google Search Console and how you can use it. Let's get started. Here's a quick summary of the changes you'll see in the new Google Search Console. It's a complete redesign to make it easier to optimize your website. There's now 16 months of data available, which means you can perform year-on-year comparisons. If there is a problem indexing pages on your website, you'll be given details about the issue and the URLs affected. There are new options for validating and checking fixes you've applied to your website. You can now share reports with other people in your organization. Now let's head to Google Search Console. The first thing you'll notice is how clean and streamlined the interface is. It's much easier to get to the information you need. On the status page, you'll see an overview of your website's performance for the last 3 months. Let's open the performance report. You will see a summary for the key metrics at the top of the report. You can see total clicks, impressions, average click-through rate, and average position. You can click on each of these metrics to include them in the reporting table. At the top of the report, you can modify the data that's included. By default, you'll be viewing data for the web search results over the last 3 months, but you can click on these to change them. For example, you can click on Search Type to then view data for image and video search results. And you can change the date range of the report to use other predefined ranges, like the last 12 months or even all the available data. You can also use the compare option to compare two date ranges to each other in the report. This is a great way to see if metrics and performance are improving. You can also focus the report further by clicking New. For example, you can choose to focus on a particular country or device. The table includes search queries by default. You can also select the Pages, Countries, and Devices tabs to update the report. So what do you think of the changes to Google Search Console? I'd love to know. Now let's head back to the status page. Below performance is index coverage. This shows you how many pages are being indexed along with any errors. And enhancements highlights ways to improve your website's appearance in search results. For example, errors and warnings about AMP pages can be highlighted. Now that we're familiar with the new interface, let's look at how we can actually use the performance report in Google Search Console. We're going to look at how to use the report to optimize our content. Here's what we need to do. Step 1. After you've selected your website in Search Console, we need to open the performance report. Step 2. At the top of the report, make sure that clicks, impressions, click-through rate, and position are all selected. This gives you all of the available data within the report. Step 3. You'll now see the search queries with the most clicks at the top of the report. Spend time identifying search queries that are relevant to your organization that have a lower than expected click-through rate. I'd recommend starting with ones that have a click-through rate that is less than 6%. This will give you a list of search queries that you can then use to optimize your content. Also keep an eye out for search queries that have a strong click-through rate, but aren't showing an average position in the top 10 organic results. There might be opportunities to optimize for these search queries too. Step 4. Click the search query that you want to optimize. This will show you the page or pages to review. Make a note of the pages you want to optimize. Step 5. Now it's time to repeat this process for your landing pages. To do this, select the Pages tab above the table. Look for pages that have a lower click-through rate. I'd recommend below 4%. If you notice a page that has a high click-through rate but a low average position, these are also worth taking a note of. You will now have a list of pages that you can optimize in order to increase their click-through rate. Next, you'll need to review the page titles and descriptions. The aim here is to make them as relevant as you can to the search queries people are using on Google. The more relevant they are, the higher the click-through rate, and the more likely your website will be higher in the organic rankings. You might decide to edit your page titles and descriptions to make them more relevant and compelling for your audience. You might also want to change the content on the page too. I recommend documenting the changes you make so that you can check back to see what you've changed and if the changes are achieving results. So that's how you can use the new Google Search Console to identify pages to optimize on your website. The new interface is streamlined and easy to use, and with the ability to view 16 months of data. Google Search Console has become even more useful for improving your content. What do you think of the new Google Search Console? Do you like the changes? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below, and if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.